Hello students, today we will study about the topic orbital contribution to total magnetic moment for high spin octahedral complexes. In last video lecture we have studied about the low spin octahedral complexes. So now we will study about high spin octahedral complexes. So these are the octahedral complexes. So the 5 orbital should not have same energy, are not degenerate, are separate into the two set of the orbitals, the T2g and Eg. T2g has low energy as compared to the Eg. So now we will discuss about the orbital contribution of the D1 to the D9 configuration. As the orbital contribution is expected or the not, that we will study. So for the D1 configuration, as the orbital contribution expected or not, the first electron goes into the T2g level. So what are these three conditions? The first one condition is that the orbital should be degenerate, and the second condition is that the orbital should have same shape and the size, and the third one condition is that when the orbital is interconverted, they should not contain the electron of the identical spin. So the three conditions are satisfied by the D1 configuration. So D1 configuration will give the orbital contribution to the total magnetic moment. So the orbital contribution is expected. Next, for the d square configuration, the orbital contribution is expected. The three conditions are fulfilled. Next, for D3, the orbital contribution is not expected. The third condition is not fulfilled, because when it is interconverted, the DZX already contain the electron with the identical spin. So the orbital contribution is not expected. For D4 configuration, so next electron goes to E. So the dx square minus y square can't be interconverted into the dz square, because in the difference in shapes. So the orbital contribution is not expected. Next, for D5, for this also the orbital contribution is not expected. This also not satisfy the second condition, that is the orbital should have same size and shape. Next, for D6, the next electron goes to the T2, because this is the high spin complexes. There are the maximum number of the unpaired electrons. So is it this electron give the orbital contribution or not? Yes, the orbital contribution is expected, because fulfilled the three conditions. Next is for D7. This also fulfilled the three conditions, so orbital contribution is expected. Next is for D8. The next electron goes to the T2. So T2 is fully filled, so the orbital contribution is not expected. Last is for D9. The next electron goes to E. So this can't be interconverted. Second condition is not satisfied, so orbital contribution is not expected. So thank you, students.